Hello friends, this presentation is about the state space modeling of a quadcopter and design of its state feedback controller. This presentation contains the introduction to quadcopter, assumptions used to make the state space model, dynamic equations of the quadcopter, state space model of the quadcopter, step response of the obtained state space model, then pole placement at the desired locations, design of the state feedback controller, step response of the system with the state feedback controller, conclusions and references. Now a quadcopter gets its name due to the presence of four propellers. If it has six propellers, then it is known as a hexacopter. If it have eight propellers, then it is known as an octacopter, and so on. Now we are interested in the state space modeling of a quadcopter. A quadcopter flies due to the thrust produced by the four propellers, and a VLDC motor is used to rotate these propellers. Since they have light weight and has the ability to rotate at high RPMs and has high efficiency, etc. Next, if you look at the animation, you can see that two diagonally opposite pairs of propeller rotates in one direction while the other pair rotates in the opposite direction. That is, the propellers A and C rotates in the clockwise direction while propellers B and D rotates in the anti-clockwise direction. Why is it so? What happens if the propellers rotates in the same direction? So the problem is that if four propellers rotate in the same direction, then due to the rotation of the propellers, a torque is produced, and due to that torque, a resultant torque or that reaction torque will cause our copter to rotate in the opposite direction. If you observe the helicopter, you can see there is a tail rotor. The purpose of the tail rotor is to cancel the resultant torque produced by the rotation of the main propeller. So here we doesn't want a tail rotor or such a type of design. Since we use four propellers, we have the option to rotate two propellers in one direction and other two propellers in the opposite direction, such that the resultant torque will cancel each other, or the reaction torque, resultant reaction torque will cancel each other. So we rotate the diagonally opposite rotors in one direction and the other pair in the opposite direction. Next, let's move to the basic terminologies of a quadcopter. Likewise, in the rectangular coordinate system, here we have x, y and z axis, but here x axis is known as the roll axis, y axis is known as the pitch axis, and z axis is known as the yaw axis. And the rotation about the x axis is known as the roll motion. Rotation about the y axis is known as the pitch motion. Rotation about the z axis is known as the yaw motion. Hovering means to remain in one place in air. To hover, the four thrust produced by the four propellers must be equal to the gravitational force pulling it down. Then the drone will hover. Next is the assumptions involved in the modeling of this quadcopter. Here the quadcopter is assumed to be a linear time invariant system. We know that in a real life, all systems are not LTI systems. But here for simplicity, we take it as a LTI system. Wind flow is not taken into consideration. Wind flow is an important parameter that affects the flight dynamics of a quadcopter. But here for simplicity, we consider a case without wind flow in ideal condition. Then the mechanical vibrations of the quadcopter is not taken into consideration. Force to moment scaling factor of all propellers are assumed to be same. These are the assumptions that we have made to model the quadcopter, to make the state space model of our quadcopter. Next, we want to discuss about the dynamic equations of our quadcopter. For discussing about the dynamic equation, we consider this figure and obtain the dynamic equations of our quadcopter. The variables used to represent different quantities are here shown here. That is, F1 is represent the force due to rotor 1, F2 force due to rotor 2, F3 force due to rotor 3, F4 force due to rotor 4, phi roll angle, theta pitch angle, psi yaw angle, tau x roll torque, tau y pitch torque, tau z yaw torque. Next, we will discuss about roll motion, pitch motion, and yaw motion using this figure. Here, roll motion means rotation about the x-axis. So, for rotation about the x-axis, the torque provided by rotor 1 and rotor 3 is 0, since their momentum is 0. It is because they lie on the x-axis. And so, the torque required for the quadcopter to rotate about the x-axis is provided by rotor 2 and rotor 4. The torque provided by rotor 2 is taken as positive and the torque provided by rotor 4 is taken as negative. It is because rotor 2 provides a clockwise torque and counterclockwise torque and rotor 4 provides a clockwise torque. Here, counterclockwise torque is taken as positive and clockwise torque is taken as negative. Next is pitch motion. For pitch motion means rotation about the y-axis. For the rotation about the y-axis, the torque provided by rotor 2 and rotor 4 is 0. It is because they lie on the y-axis and their momentum is 0. So the required torque is provided by rotor 1 and rotor 3. Torque provided by rotor 1 is taken as positive since they provide torque in the counterclockwise direction, and rotor 3 is taken as negative since they provide torque in the clockwise direction. Next is yaw motion. It means the rotation of a quadcopter about the z-axis, and it is achieved by varying the relative RPM of the clockwise and counterclockwise rotating propeller pairs. If the RPM of clockwise rotating propeller is more than that of the counterclockwise rotating propeller, then the resultant torque is in the clockwise direction and the reactive torque is in the counterclockwise direction. So our drone or the quadcopter will rotate in the counterclockwise direction. And if vice versa or in the opposite, if we do it in the opposite way, then the quadcopter will rotate in the clockwise direction. Thereby the yaw motion can be achieved. Our next objective is to obtain equations for the rotation along x-axis, y-axis, and z-axis. That is the tau x, tau y, and tau z. So the equation for roll motion is given by tau x is equal to r2 minus rf4. This is because the force produced by or the torque produced by rotor 1 and rotor 3 about the x-axis is 0, because their momentum is 0 as discussed earlier, and the torque produced by rotor 2 is taken in positive and rotor 4 is taken in negative direction since they rotate in counterclockwise and clockwise direction respectively. Next is pitch motion or rotation along y-axis. Here, as said earlier, the torque provided by rotor 2 and rotor 4 are 0 since their momentum is 0, and here the torques are provided by the rotor 1 and rotor 3. So tau y is equal to rf1 minus rf3. Here the torque provided by rotor 1 is taken in positive direction and rotor 3 is taken in negative direction since they rotate in counterclockwise and clockwise direction respectively. Next is the yaw motion. We have already discussed how the yaw motion occurs, and the torque required for the yaw motion is given by the equation C into minus f1 plus f2 minus f3 plus f4. Here, the torque provided by rotor 1 and 3 are taken in the negative direction since they rotate in the counterclockwise direction. Here, C is the force to moment scaling factor for a diesel motor propeller set, and it can be calculated experimentally. So we can obtain the angular acceleration as applied torque by rotational moment of inertia. Using this equation, equation 1, 2 and 3 can be modified. That is these equations can be modified, and phi double dash, where phi is the roll angle, phi double dash is equal to r into f2 minus f4 by ix, where r into f2 minus f4 is tau x. which we have already found here. Here, tau x is equal to r into f2 minus f1. So we get phi double dash is equal to r into f2 minus f4 by ax, theta double dash is equal to tau y by iy, tau y is r into f1 minus f3 by iy, and phi double dash is equal to c into minus f1 plus f2 minus f3 plus f4 by iz, that is tau z by iz. Tau z is we have already found it here. Our next objective is to find the equation for the vertical motion. In the vertical motion of a quadrupod, it is governed by total thrust force T and weight W along the z axis. So we can write here thrust is equal to force plus the weight of the quadrupod. From Newton's second law, we can write F is equal to ma. We can take F to the left side and thrust to the right side. And we get it as F is equal to T minus mg, or A is equal to T minus mg by M. Here acceleration along the z-axis is z double dash is equal to T minus mg by M. And T minus mg is nothing but F. Here F is the force produced by all the four propellers, that is F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus F4. So z double dash is equal to minus of F1 plus F2 plus F3 plus F4 by M. Next is horizontal motion. For a drone to move along X and Y axis, it is achieved by decreasing the relatively increasing and decreasing the speed of the or RPM of the propellers. If I want to move my quadcopter forward, the RPM of forward propeller bias has to be decreased and backward propeller bias has to be increased. Then there is a component of force around the thrust. Then the thrust have a horizontal component or the component along the forward direction, which will move the quadcopter in the forward direction. If I want to move it in the backward direction, I want to do it the opposite of what I have done before. Next is, in order to move the quadcopter in the towards the sides, if I want to move my quadcopter towards the left side, then I want to decrease the RPM of propellers in the left side and increase the RPM of propellers in the right side. Then our quadcopter will tilt towards the left side, and there is a resultant force or thrust along the left side. So our quadcopter will move towards the left side. Then our next objective is to form an equation for this horizontal motion. So x double dash, or the acceleration along the x axis, is the thrust along x axis by m. Thrust along the horizontal direction or x axis is minus t sine theta. T sine theta is the component of thrust along the horizontal axis or the x axis, minus t sine theta by m. Here the tilting of the drone with respect to the horizontal or with respect to the ground is very small. The angle is very small, so sin theta can be taken as approximately equal to theta. So we can write the thrust is equal to minus mg theta, and x double dash is equal to minus d theta. Like very so similarly, we can find y double dash is equal to g phi. Here we have designed our quadcopter for 6 degree of freedom. So we have total state variables. X1 is equal to x, that is the position along x axis. X2 is equal to y, position along y axis. X3 is equal to z, position along z axis. X4 is equal to x dash, velocity along x axis. X5 is equal to y dash, velocity along y axis. X6 is equal to z dash, velocity along z axis. X7 is equal to phi roll angle. X8 is equal to theta pitch angle. X9 is equal to psi angle. X10 is equal to phi dash roll rate. X11 is equal to theta dash pitch rate. X12 is equal to psi dash yaw rate. Next is the state differential equation. So here x1 dash is equal to x4, x2 dash is equal to x5, x3 dash is equal to x6. All these equations are derived in the previous slides. x1 dash is equal to minus g theta, x5 dash is equal to g5, x6 dash is equal to minus of f1 plus f2 plus f3 plus f4 by m, x7 dash is equal to x10, x8 dash is equal to x11, x9 dash is equal to x12, x10 dash is equal to r into f2 minus f4 by ax, x11 dash is equal to r into f1 minus f3 by ay, x12 dash is equal to c into minus f1 plus f2 minus f3 plus f4 by iz. So next is the state space model of our quadcopter. The state equation is x dash of t is equal to a into x of t plus b into u of t, where x of t is the state vector and a is the system matrix, b is the output matrix, u of t is the input vector, and our system is a 12th order system as shown in this slide. We obtained this matrix form is obtained from the equations that we have derived in the previous slides. Output equation is y of t is equal to c into x of t plus d into u of t, where y of t is the output vector, c is the output matrix, u of t is the input vector, d is the feed forward matrix, and we obtain it as shown in this slide. Next is, in order to move forward, here we have obtained the state equation and the output equation is a general form of a state space model for a quadcopter in a 6 degree of freedom. Next, we want to obtain the step response and other parameters for this state space model. In order to do that, we want to find the we want to give value to the physical quantities like mass, moment of inertia about x, y, z axis, then the distance between the center of the quadcopter and the propeller, etc. So we have selected a reference paper, and from that paper the physical values for physical quantities are selected. Mass is mass for our model is 0.5 kilogram, distance between the center of the cord and propeller is 0.25 meter, moment of inertia about x axis is 0.0196 kilogram meter square, moment of inertia about y axis is 0.0196 kilogram meter square, moment of inertia about z axis is 0.0264 kilogram meter square. Force to moment scaling factor c is 0.1 meter inverse, acceleration due to gravity is minus 9.81 meter per second square. Here the moment of inertia are calculated experimentally, and the analytical determination does not give a accurate value since the shape of a quadcopter is very complex. So for getting accurate value, we use experimental methods to find out the moment of inertia over x, y, and z axis. We have gotten these values from the reference paper. Next is, after substituting the values of the design parameters, we get A, B, C and D matrices as these. Next is, we want to get the step response of the state space model of our quadcopter. In order to get the step response in MATLAB, first we want to define A, B, C, D matrices. Next, we want to define the height as the state space model using SS of A, B, C, D. Using that command, we can define it as the state space model. Then the step of our state space model, step of the variable used to represent our state space model gives the step response, and it will look like this. Here, the out one represents X, out two position along Y axis, out three position along Z axis. This is phi, that is the roll angle, theta, that is the pitch angle, out 6 means psi, that is the yaw angle. Input 1, input 2, input 3, input 4 means f1, f2, f3, f4 in our case. By observing this step response, we can see that here the response doesn't settle down. Here also the response doesn't settle down. Here the response is not settling. Here the response is not settling. Here and here also the response is not settling. So according to Bebo stability criteria, we can say that our system is unstable because for bounded input, we doesn't get bounded output. So in order to make it stable, first we want to choose our desired pole locations. Next, our objective is to select the desired pole locations. Here, the desired pole locations are chosen according to dominant pole approach. And here we take the settling time is 1 second and damping ratio is 0.8. The equation for settling time with 5% tolerance is, with 2% tolerance is 4 by zeta omega n. Here we have the value of zeta settling time and we get the value for omega n as, or the natural frequency as 5 hertz. Substituting this in the characteristic equation of a second order system, that is square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square is equal to 0. We get the characteristic equation as square plus 8 s plus 25 is equal to 0, and the solution for this equation gives the location of poles, and we get S1 is equal to minus 4 plus 3a and S2 is equal to minus 4 minus 3a. So, the location of two poles are found out. Then our next objective is to place the remaining 10 poles. Here this is a 12th order system, so there are 12 poles. Among the 12 poles, 2 poles are find out using the find out. Since we use the dominant pole approach here, these are the dominant poles, S1 and S2. Other poles can be placed away from these poles towards the left side of it. Its influence on the response will be negligible. Next is the state feedback controller design. Since this is a higher order system, we use MATLAB to find the state feedback for the design of the state feedback controller. And the code, MATLAB code for the design of the state feedback controller is as shown below. First, we want to define A, B, C and D matrix. So next is the design of the state feedback controller. Since this is a higher order system, the design of the state feedback controller here is done using MATLAB. The MATLAB code for designing the state feedback controller is shown here. First, we want to define the A, B, C, and D matrices. It is not shown here since the size of the A, B, C, and D matrices are very large, and it has already discussed in the previous slides. First, we want to define that matrices, then for the MATLAB command to represent it as a state space model is SS of ABCD. Then we want to define the vector P which contains the 12 poles. Here our dominant poles are minus 4 plus 3 I and minus 4 minus 3 A, and other poles can be placed away from these poles towards the left side of these four, such that their response can be negligible. Next is we want to determine the state feedback controller, and it can be determined using the command place A comma B comma P, and we want to modify our state matrix such that we will get a state matrix for a system with state feedback controller. So we can modify our state matrix as AC is equal to A minus B into K. Then the state space model of the system with the feedback controller is S of ACL, comma B, comma C, comma D. While doing this program, we must make sure that our system is, or our state space model is completely state controllable. Otherwise, when we execute this program, we get error. We can't find out K. We can find out K only if our system is or the state space model is fully state controllable. And we get the K matrix from MATLAB as shown in this slide. Next is the step response with the state feedback controller. Here you can see that all the responses settle down, and that is for a bounded input we get bounded output. So according to BIBO stability criteria, our system is stable. this is a comparison between the response with and without feedback controller. So without feedback controller, we can see that the responses, the responses are not settling down, and this will make our system unstable. But here, when we use this feedback controller, it will make our system stable, and its settling time and damping ratio can be chosen according to our will or according to our need. Next is the conclusions that we have made when doing this design. So we can design a quadcopter using a state space approach. For a higher order system, dominant pole approach can be used to find the desired pole locations. While choosing desired pole locations, accuracy and the precision of the sensors and actuators has to be kept in mind. That is, we can't select any fancy pole locations which is very far away from the origin. It depends upon the accuracy and the precision of our sensors and actuators. In case of a drone, the sensors are accelerometers, gyroscope, etc., and the actuators are really small. So we want to keep the eye in our sensors and actuators. Then, and according to that only we have to select the pole locations. Otherwise, our ideal design does not work in the practical world, and it will highly dependent on the accuracy and precision of the sensors and actuators. Then using feedback controller, we can improve the stability of our quadcopter. Feedback controller has more flexibility than the classical controllers. That is, here we can choose the pole locations according to our need. In the classical controllers, we doesn't have the option to choose pole locations according to our need or to our design. But here we have the more flexibility and freedom to choose the pole locations. But one thing has to be kept in mind, the precision and accuracy of our sensors and actuators will highly affect it. And it has also to be kept in mind while choosing the pole locations. Otherwise, our practical system will fail to work. These are the references. Thank you.